Hi everyone, I'm Abhinandan Nag. Today in this video, we are going to discuss on what electronics does, which mainly consists of ECU, sensors, and actuators. So yeah, let's get started. High-tech systems started appearing in the cars in the 1980s, and today, auto electronic systems and instant computers do everything from regulating fuel to diagnosing problems. Most of today's cars have between 30 to 80 separate electronic controllers. Some of these have a noticeable effect on safety. Adaptive cruise control slows the vehicle down if another car is detected in front of it. All lane assist systems, which warn a driver if they are leaving or the lane without signaling. These are just two examples. In-car computers, they give the drivers a way to control multiple devices from inside the car. However, a sensor with simple job like detecting the outside temperature, these also perform critical tasks that directly affect the safety on the road. For example, a sensor might measure the car's angle to keep it in the right gear while accelerating. Or sensors might sense slipping wheels in a lousy weather, signaling the car to turn on electric stability control. So yeah, as technology advances, we are yet to see more sophisticated electronic gadgets or equipments that play an important role. Higher the segment of your car, it will directly add to the number of such advancement systems. The next unit that we are going to discuss about is ECU, or the engine control unit. The ECU is the engine's brain that controls the entire functioning of the engine. It serves several functions that includes the regulating and maintaining the amount of fuel and the air and the fuel injection part that helps in increasing the horsepower of the engine. If any problem occurs in the electrical part or any other part of the automotive, it's a must that you check the ECU. After all, you don't risk anything that you relate yourself to your car functioning. And that is the reason which makes it the most important part of the automotive. Primary function of the ECU, or the engine control unit, is the controlling of the series of operations of actuators or an internal combustion engine that ensures excellent engine performance. It is therefore also called to as the powertrain control unit. Within the engine bay, ECU takes the values from many sensors, then interprets the data by using multidimensional performance maps. In this way, adjusts the engine actuators accordingly. It is also responsible for the best engine performance. So engine control module, or ECM, is the same as engine control unit, ECU. The difference is that if we name the overall combined section of the ECUs, then we call it an ECM. Okay. Next up is the role of sensors. The role of sensors is massive in automotive. They enable more significant degrees of vehicle automation and futuristic designs. For example, the manufacturing unit, robotic arm, are used for painting the car bodies and measuring the thickness of the coatings being applied. In addition, manufacturers can monitor the thickness of the paint being sprayed on the instruments, airbag claddings, and various internal parts of the vehicles using sensors. Sensors monitor the vehicle engines, fuel consumptions, and emissions, along with aiding and protecting the drivers and the passengers. These allow the manufacturers to launch the cars that are safer, much more fuel efficient, and comfortable to drive. In overall, sensors have a huge impact to control the overall working of the automotive. Next up is the is a table that you'll see in this. When a control system includes a feedback loop, then the systems are known to as the feedback control systems. So the output is controlled accurately by providing the feedback to the input. This type of control system can include more than one feedback. In the above diagram, the error detector generates an error signal, So this is the input signal variation and the feedback signal. It can also obtain this feedback signal from feedback element in the control system by considering the system input as an system output as an input. As an alternative to the feedback given, this error signal can also be can be given as an input of a controller. Consequently, controller generates an actuating signal to the controller plant. In this arrangement, the control system output can automatically be correct to get the preferred outcome. Therefore, these systems are also called to as the automatic control systems. A closed loop control system is the best example of it, including a sensor's output. Last but not the least, the sensor calibration. The sensor calibration basically is the differences that are occurring. Sensors are electronic devices. These are sensitive to changes in the working environment. Undesirable and sudden changes in the working environment of the sensors give undesirable outputs. Thus, the exact output differs from the measured output. This comparison between the expected output and the measured output is called to as the sensor calibration. Sensor calibration plays a huge role in increasing the performance. It's used to measure the structural errors. What structural errors? It's basically the difference between the expected value and the measured value. Yeah. So you can understand how much of a difference it makes. There's more of things that are being controlled by our subsystem, but that is the main things that we exactly work on. Yeah, thank you.